yes, I'm playing with my toys. The little one, but the big one that's behind me, let's talk about what I plan to do to the real thing, because I'm just having too much fun here on the bench with this guy. Greetings, viewers. It's me, Eric the Car Guy, and yes, we are finally getting started on Dad's truck build. Very excited about this. I'm teaming up with Summit Racing. They're hooking me up with some of the parts, not all the parts, but some of the parts, but I'm doing all the work. And you're gonna come along with me, and I think you're gonna like what I have in store for this truck. The reason I refer to this as Dad's truck is because it used to be my dad's truck. In fact, he used to use it to haul his boat around, but he recently retired. He gave the boat to my brother, and I got the truck. Personally, I think I got the better end of the deal. I love this truck. It's beautiful. Like I said, Dad took really good care of it. I would like to make it a little bit better, though. In fact, what I'm trying to do, this is my time frame. It's mid-January 2019 now. I'm trying to have this thing up and running and ready to go by the Power Tour 2019, because I would like to do the Power Tour with my dad, where I drive the Fairmont and he drives this. So let's talk a little bit about what I plan to do between now and then. Many people confuse this truck with this model, which is a 454 SS. This truck does not have a 454 in it. Instead, it has a 350. My truck is a 1990 C1500 Sport, not a 454 SS. Now, originally this truck came with a manual transmission. Before my dad bought it, somebody converted it over to an automatic. And honestly, I'm gonna stick with the automatic. And there's several reasons for that, but I think at the top of that list is my wife also likes this truck and will probably wanna drive it at some point. So having an automatic gets me an in. It also makes it so that as I get parts for this thing, I won't hear too much about it. It's a truck for you, honey. And I'm very lucky to have friends at Monster Transmission who are gonna put together that automatic transmission for me. Thanks, Monster. Now for the suspension on the truck, I plan to lower it. And I'm gonna do this in two stages, or I should say possibly two stages, and I'm gonna talk about stage one right now. So for phase one in the rear, the intention is to come in and change the mounts where the leaf spring mounts to the frame. And in doing so, it's gonna move those mounts further up inside the body, which should be good for a 4-inch drop in the rear. Now for the front phase one, the plan is to install a set of 2-inch drop spindles, and that means the center of this wheel where it mounts onto the spindle on the inside there is going to be moved up 2 inches, which will drop the front 2 inches. So it'll be a 4 2-inch drop to start with in phase one. Say I do phase one and I decide the truck isn't quite low enough and I want to go lower. In the rear, I have this option. I can take the axle, which is now mounted below the leaf springs, and move it above the leaf springs. However, I'm going to have to do a couple of things in order to make that happen. First, I'm going to have to install shock mounts or extended shock mounts so that I can install the dampers so they won't be at some weird angle. The next thing I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to cut and notch the frame to allow accommodation for the axle to move up and down as the suspension moves. So that's a bit more extreme, but it's good for, I believe, another 4 inches here in the rear. Now, to drop the truck further in the front, if I go to phase two, what I'll do is I'll install different coil springs that are good for a 3-inch drop in the fronts for a total of a 5-inch drop in the front, 8-inch drop in the rear. And that's a maybe on phase two. First, I'm going to do phase one and see where we're at. I have always liked the wheels and tires that are originally on this truck. However, I want to update it a little bit, but still stick to the period of the 90s, which is kind of the theme that I'm going for with the truck. So what I've done is I got a set of almost the identical wheel in 17-inch. So this is 2 inches up from what's on there now. Also, it has that zero offset, but I've checked and turned the wheel side to side, and so far I don't see any clearance issues. I'm really gonna have to test that when I get the tires on here and the suspension lowered. To go with the bigger set of wheels, I got some bigger tires. I picked up the set of these General Grabber UHPs, which are similar to what I'm running on the Fairmont that I have been happy with, and these are 255 60 17s. I originally went looking for a set of white letter tires because I like the white letter tire look on this truck with the black. I think it looks really great, but I had a hard time tracking down a set of white letter tires. Late last year, I was going to car shows and I started seeing some cars with white letter tires and I wondered where they got them. So I asked and they said, well, you actually buy the letters separate and glue them onto the tire. So I found the website, and I believe that's the direction I'm going to take. Well, I have to now because I couldn't find white letter tires, but I'm going to glue on my own white letters onto these tires so I can have white letter tires on my truck. So in addition to lowering the suspension, I'm also going to replace all the dampers with Bilstein units. Now, along with phase one, I'm going to have to remove the upper and lower control arms and everything anyway, so this coil spring is going to have to come out. Coil springs get old over time, they kind of sag, and there's nothing that appears to be wrong with these, but I might replace them with just original equipment for phase one. However, I am concerned that that may raise things up in the front a little bit as a result. I'm just not sure on this, because if I go to phase three, I will be replacing the coil coil springs anyway. But with phase one, my concern is that one of these coil springs is sagging and the ride height's not quite right. And since I'm gonna have it out anyway, why not replace it then? So I'm still debating on whether or not I'm gonna do that. I've complained about it in the past. This braking system sucks, and apparently I'm not alone because a lot of people with these trucks have a similar complaint. I'm gonna dump the ABS, it's only rear ABS anyway. I'm also gonna dump the master cylinder, and I'm considering replacing the booster, but as good as that looks, I don't think I'll have to do that. But the idea is to end up with a nice, firm brake pedal that actually stops the truck instead of this smooshy thing that's kind of scary every time that somebody panic stops in front of you the way it is now. I'm also gonna lose these drum brakes and swap these out for discs, so I'll be doing a drum to disc conversion here in the back. For the front brakes, I intend to install a new set of slotted rotors and some performance brake pads to help things stop a little better up front. I'd love to install larger rotors and bigger brakes and that type of thing, but you may notice this, and I already loosened this, it doesn't just sit like this. Where that caliper mounts is actually part of the knuckle assembly, so swapping out for bigger rotors and calipers isn't necessarily an option. However, I do believe there is a set of calipers out there with dual pistons instead of the single piston like this one has. I'm gonna wait until after I've installed the rear brakes and the new braking system to see how it stops. If I feel it needs more, well, then we'll look into these calipers. But for now, I'm just gonna install the upgraded rotors and brake pads. I'm also gonna upgrade to some steel braided brake lines. I'm hoping all those upgrades actually give me that firm pedal feel that I'm hoping for, especially with the kind of power that I'll be putting through this truck. As you can see, I've got 182,000 on the truck as it sits now, but I've never really been happy with this gauge cluster setup. These goofy looking gauges were on these early model trucks. Later model trucks, they came out with a different gauge cluster setup that is analog and looks better in my opinion. However, I'm not gonna switch to that. In fact, I think I'm gonna hit up my friends at Speed Hut again and put in a new speedometer, a new tachometer, also a new temperature gauge, new oil pressure, new fuel gauge, also volt gauge. However, this time, I think I'm also going to add, since I'm running an automatic transmission, a transmission temperature gauge. Another thing that I've never liked about the dash on this is these goofy radios that they put into these. I plan on replacing that also. I'm sure several of you out there are most excited about what's going to happen here underneath the hood. And I've gone through a few ideas on this, all the way from getting an LQ4 for my neighbor that's next door and getting some Cadillac CTSV cylinder heads and intake and putting it on here and having a supercharged LS, which, let's face it, would be awesome, but stupid expensive. And to that end, I came around to the idea of, you know what, looking at this 350, there's nothing wrong with it. My dad took great care of it. There's a lot of stuff available in the aftermarket for a 350, so I'm gonna stick with the 350 and build that. Let's talk about the specifics. As I mentioned, there is a ton of stuff in the aftermarket for the 350. It's readily available and relatively cheap when you think about it, much cheaper than that LS that I mentioned. Yeah, that would be cool, but I'm trying to keep this as more of an everyman type of build. I'm basically gonna toss everything up top though, so I'm gonna get rid of the cylinder heads and the intake manifold and just stick with the block that's in here. Now I'm gonna go through and measure that block, measure the cylinders and everything, and if everything's okay, I'm not gonna opt for any machining at all. If I need to maybe clean something up, I might bore the cylinders out 30 over or something like that to make them a little larger. However, I would like to get a stroker crank kit for the bottom end and turn this into a 383 stroker, which is something you can do to a 350. So you're increasing the stroke length on the piston and therefore increasing the displacement of the engine that way. It's quite a popular thing to do. All the kids are doing it these days. I'm going to start by getting rid of these wussy stock cylinder heads and replacing them with a set of AFR 180cc cylinder heads. AFR makes a couple of cylinder heads. One of them is in a 180cc, the other is in a 195cc. The 195cc would be more of a race type of cylinder head. I'm going to stick with the more streetable 180cc because basically I'll be using this truck on the street, not the racetrack. This time I want to keep things simple. So instead of a turbocharger or a supercharger, I'm just going to go naturally aspirated. However, I'm going to switch this over to multi-port fuel injection. Now I'm still tossing around a couple of different systems that I'm considering, but in the end I would like this to be a multi-port fuel injected 350, 383 stroker, just really awesome engine that puts out somewhere in the neighborhood of 400 to 500-ish horsepower. As far as the accessories go, I'm going to update all of those, including the air conditioning, and probably hit up my friends at CVF Racing when I do that. I also want to get rid of this clutch fan that's in here and swap that out for an electric unit that is on a new radiator that's able to handle the kind of heat that the engine I anticipate will make. To feed a higher horsepower engine, I'm likely going to have to upgrade the fuel pump, which I will do, and maybe some other components within the fuel system, but I know for sure I'm going to have to upgrade the fuel pump. A truck came originally equipped with this 10 bolt rear end, which I am going to keep. However, I'm going to upgrade it a bit. I'm going to install a set of 373 gears back here. I'm also going to install a new differential with a cone style limited slip. Well, there it is. My plans to build Dad's truck. It's not like the Fairmont. It's not my first build either, so I've taken some of the stuff that I've learned from that and applied it to this. In that, I'm not going so pie in the sky, forced induction, mass horsepower with this thing. I want to do this build as something that if somebody owned one of these trucks, they could do it themselves in their own garage and end up with a much better truck on the other side of it. I'm even wanting to do a series on the engine assembly and do all that stuff myself. Point being, I don't want this thing to go overboard. I want it to come out cool and functioning on the other side. I want my dad to be able to drive it on the power tour, which, you know, it's going to be over a thousand miles for that whole thing. I'll put links in the description to the parts and things that I've mentioned that I know I'm getting so far, but plans might change slightly along the way, but you've got the general idea. If you have automotive questions, I ask that you head to EricTheCarGuy.com. That will be linked in the description along with additional stuff. So check the description for additional stuff, right? Please be sure to comment, like, subscribe, and do all those things that help make a living. I really appreciate that. Be safe, have fun, stay dirty. I hope to see you as I go on this journey of Dad's truck build. The truck originally came with this 10 bolt rear end, which I'm going to stick with. However, I'm going to upgrade it with a set of 373 gears and a limited slip cone type blah, 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 blah.